And today we are in the beautiful city of Nottingham. We are at Shani's Hair and Beauty Lounge, and I've got with me here today lovely Chantel, Chantel Mugufa. Chantel is also known as Shanene. So, Chantel, say hello to everyone.
Hello everyone, how are you? Shanene is in the building.
She's in the building indeed, and today she's gonna do my makeup. She says she can do it in 20 minutes.
Yes,
so
fine.
Take a look at my face now, and then in 20 minutes you'd have another look and see the difference. Chantel is good at what she does. So yeah, I'm looking forward to it. We'll take some beautiful pictures. And I bet by tomorrow there'll be a long queue outside there.
Hopefully.
5,000 people. Can you manage?
All the time. I will be able to manage.
I'm sure you can manage. Shani's lounge is really big. There are some rooms upstairs. How many rooms?
I've got about 4 to 5 rooms.
Okay, that's really big. I noticed when we came in earlier, there were many clients here. And that shows that you're really, really busy.
Yeah, always busy, always booked up.
So how do you manage them?
Okay, when I have things that are like short styles, or they don't take that long, I work on my own. But if I'm very, very busy, I've got two other ladies that come to help me. So they are self-employed, but we just work around each other's schedule.
Oh, that sounds interesting. So, how long have you been in the hair and beauty business?
I've been doing hair for about 13 years.
Wow,
I was a mobile hairdresser, and then professionally for about 3 years.
Wow, that's really good.
Yes.
So, what are you doing to my face now?
Okay, right now I'm just putting some banana powder on your face, just to
banana
highlight.
Banana powder?
Yes, banana powder.
She's putting banana powder. What's special about banana powder?
Banana powder is just to highlight your face. Yes, to give it that glow.
Okay.
Yes.
What about orange powder?
Orange powder?
Not as good as banana powder.
I don't really use orange powder, to be honest. I prefer banana powder.
I don't even know if there's orange powder. It's just me talking.
you got me twisted again, because I was confused myself. What are you talking about?
No, it's just me thinking of other colors.
Okay. Don't worry, I'll make you look beautiful.
So you do hair and beauty and makeup and stuff for weddings and stuff like that?
Yes, sometimes, but not too much. But I do get lots of people who call in. I've done about 3 weddings now, so, and I've done lots of party makeup. So, yeah.
Wow, that's really good. So for the wedding stuff, do people have to come in to Shani's, or you go?
I can travel.
Okay.
Yes. The furthest that I've traveled was in Gibraltar.
Wow.
Yeah, for a wedding.
And how was it out there?
It was really good.
Wow.
Yeah.
Did they pay you a lot of money?
Kind of. I didn't really get the money, to be honest.
I'm not going to ask you how much you paid, of course, so, you know.
Yeah, of course, if I go and do a job like that, then I have to get paid. But when I did it, it wasn't about the money. It was about just going and, you know, helping out a friend and having fun.
Okay, so guess what? I would like to invite you to do my hair for my wedding and my makeup. How much will you charge me?
Okay, I start from £450 for the bride and 6 bridesmaids. Yeah, that's a package. So what we do the makeup and we style the hair.
So for me, is it going to be same price, or is it going to be lower, or is it going to be higher?
You're going to pay me £1,000 today.
Ooh, she wants £1,000. Anyway, we'll see in 20 minutes. If my face looks as good as yours, then I might just pay 2,000. No problem.
No problem.
Yes.
As long as I'm getting paid.
Okay, no problem. So, this city of Nottingham, how is the competition then?
We do have quite a few hairdressers, to be honest. On the street, we've got about 4 Afro-Caribbean hairdressers. The competition, I don't know about the competition, to be honest, because I've always had a lot of clients who still come back to me. So I don't feel like I'm competing with anyone, to be honest, because I do have the clientele.
Wow, that's really good. after you notice some salons are closing down, what do you think is happening?
It's probably poor management, to be honest. Or maybe they're closing down for other reasons that I might not know. Because today I might close down and then you probably say, oh, she says poor management, you know. But no, if I have to shut down, I'll be shutting down probably for health reasons.
Okay.
Because my, you know, well, with hairdressing, you get back pains, you get arthritis, you get things like that. And with my hands now, I'm starting to feel that.
Okay.
It's something that I've always been thinking about, you know, to say, okay, if my hands and my legs go, what next am I going to do? So I always have a backup plan.
So do you want to tell us your backup plan, or is it a secret?
It's a secret.
Okay.
You'll know later.
She's not going to let the cat out of the bag. It's a secret. And how soon are we going to know?
Watch this space. That's all I can say.
Okay, that sounds interesting. We'll keep watching.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll keep watching. So what's happening now? What are you doing and why? What's happening?
It's part of the highlighting.
Okay.
So what I did is just to make your nose look slender.
Ooh.
Yeah. So we just used a darker shade of the lighter. So, you know, just to make you look.
Ooh, I can see the difference already.
Can you?
Yes, I can see a difference on my face. You do a good job. No wonder why you're always busy.
Thank you.
So she's just working with her hands.
Mm-hmm.
She's highly skilled in what she does. She's the top of the town at the moment.
Yes.
Everyone was saying Shani's. The gentleman who came here as well,
yes.
He was coming to book an appointment for his wife.
Yes, definitely.
I think there are a lot of good men out there who like the women to look beautiful.
It's very, very important.
One man came in and booked an appointment for his wife, but his wife doesn't know. It's going to be a surprise for her.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Were you busy like Valentine's time?
I'm always busy Valentine's. Mother's Day, I'm always busy. Sometimes I have to open on a Sunday because I cannot afford to do everybody's hair.
Okay.
So I have to open the shop on Sunday. So I can work like 7 days a week.
Wow.
Non-stop. The most I've worked was 21 days non-stop.
Mm-hmm.
That's how busy I was.
That sounds really busy. I think
yes.
You're even busier than the bees.
Always a busy bee.
Busy bee. Busy
bee.
Busy
Shanane.
Busy Shanane. Youth Lounge.
Can I just be picked in? You've got very nice eyebrows.
Really?
So yes, I love
Ooh.
The shape. So I'm not going to do a lot. I'm just going to, you know, darken them a little bit. Yeah?
I didn't know my eyebrows were nice. You're the first person to tell me.
Is it?
I think the others don't tell me because they're jealous, probably.
Mm. Yeah, very beautiful.
Oh, thank you, Shanane. So, this name, Shanane, what else can we expect from Shanane? Sounds really good.
That's a brand name, actually.
Mm-hmm.
I am planning to have a lot of brands with the name Shanane.
Okay, what brands are you thinking of? Is it a secret as well?
No, that's not a secret. I'm going to share it.
Okay.
I'm going to have a makeup brand called Shanane.
Wow.
And I'm also going to call my wigs Shanane, like Wigs by Shanane.
Oh, that sounds really interesting. So are you going to have a factory or are you just going to be producing it like from the salon?
Yeah, just from the salon, to be honest, for now. And then we'll see how big it will grow.
Okay, so I think the other people out there with their beauty product are in for some competition then.
Yes, they are.
Shanane is coming your way.
Yes, I'm going to have shampoos, I'm going to have hair oils, everything to do with hair and makeup.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to have brands with the name Shanane on it.
Wow, I think I'll be your first customer. Is there a special discount for the first few customers?
Oh yes, there will be. There will be.
Okay.
Alright.
Sounds good.
Now when you do something like this, it's really.
So about the hair now, how long do you take to do like crochet?
It takes me about 2.5 hours for crochet twist. Not even 2.5 hours, about 2 hours to be honest, because they're faster. And then if I'm doing the curly crochet, it will take me about 3 hours.
So which is the popular style, the hairstyle at the moment?
It's the crochet, to be honest.
Why the crochet? What is?
Because it's quicker. It's quicker to do. Because remember, people used to have single plaits, and they used to take longer. It would take maybe 5 to 6 hours to do them. Okay. But with the crochet, it just takes less time. So people actually prefer doing the crochet now.
Okay, so when you look at your diary, do you think you are having more customers than usual because you're doing more crochet rather
than single plaits? Yes, I am definitely having more clients because the crochet is faster and people prefer to do that.
Okay, so this means that the business is booming then?
Yes, it is booming.
Oh, that sounds really good. Yes. So one day when I get broke, I know where to come and get some money. It's Shanene at Shani's. I'll come knocking on your door at Shani's and say, oh, business is booming here.
Oh dear. You're going to get me robbed now.
Oh, please don't rob her.
Oh my God.
She's got 5 bodyguards. She moves around with 5 bodyguards. What are your bodyguards
everywhere? And CCTV everywhere.
Yeah, you need that. She's making so much money like that.
This is that mini rush, but I would have really, really highlighted them nice and well. Yeah.
Yes, Chantel is going to finish my makeup in 20 minutes time, so we are watching the clock.
Mm-hmm.
We are watching. Wow, I like that. Really nice.
What colors do you like?
Oh, I don't know what I like. I just like nice things. As long as it's nice. As long as you can make my face look different.
Yeah, definitely.
Mm-hmm. I like the way you've shaped my eyebrows.
Oh, thank you.
Not a lot of people can do my eyebrows. I don't know why. What do you think?
I think eyebrows on makeup is the hardest, to be honest. Everybody struggles with eyebrows. Not everyone. There are some people who are really, really good. Even on myself, I really do struggle with my eyebrows. So, yeah, I'm getting used to it, you know. I'm actually getting better with eyebrows on myself now than before.
And what do you think about threading?
Threading is actually better than tweezing, to be honest. Threading lasts longer, but sometimes with threading, some people have very sensitive skin, so they end up tearing and it will leave you with scars. So if you've got very sensitive skin on your eyebrows, I'll suggest not to thread. Just have it, you know, tweezed out. Just tweezed out, because if you use wax, it's the same thing.
Okay. And other people go to bed with makeup on. What are the advantages or disadvantages of doing that?
Makeup, it will just block your pores, to be honest. And it's not good. Like if I go to bed with makeup, if I wake up in the morning, my skin is very blotchy.
Okay.
And I end up having like rash as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it's not good to sleep with your makeup on.
Okay. Yeah. And how often should people use cleansers?
Twice a day.
Okay.
Yeah.
There you go. Chantel telling you about beauty, about hair. If you'd like to have your hair done or makeup, Shani's is in Nottingham. Shani's Lounge. What's the address again?
Shani's Beauty Lounge is 394 Alfreton Road.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, in Nottingham. NG75N.
Okay. That's very good. I can't wait to see when you finish. I bet you my driver is not going to recognize me when I come out of here.
You'll be like, madam. You're looking hot.
So next time we'll be joining Shanice when she's gonna do my hair. I would like to have the crochet.
Mm-hmm.
I've never had the crochet done before. So when you do the crochet, do you use the extension or you just first do the cornrows?
I do the cornrows first at the bottom, mm-hmm. and then I crochet the hair.
Okay.
Yes, I really, really love working with the crochet. It is amazing.
Do you think you could teach me to do crochet?
Yeah, I could teach you. Why not?
Okay. I'm just checking to see,
yes, I could teach you.
See if you're kind enough to do that.
Yes.
So do you take on students like placements and stuff or just people?
I do take on students who want placements. Like I've got a lady, she's at university at the minute, so she comes to help me out when I'm very, very busy. Because she loves doing hair, but she's not doing hair actually, mm-hmm. really, but she just loves doing it. It's a passion. So she comes to help out, which is free. So I don't mind really like teaching other people as well, you know.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, so like people in the community who are not doing anything, are they welcome to come to you?
Yes, they are welcome.
Okay.
I'm willing to teach anyone who is really, really interested, to be honest.
Okay, that's really good. Still here at Shani's, I'm not falling asleep,
mm-hmm.
just letting her do what she does best.
I'm just trying to be quick.
Okay, that's good. If you've not joined us before, if you've not heard about us before, we're News of the South, and you can check us online, www.newsofthesouth.com. We give you everything that you'd like to hear. Whether it's happening in the community, be it business, we give you motivational stories, there is so much. So all you gotta do, like us on Facebook, on our Facebook page. You can follow us on Twitter as well. We have regular updates every time, and we aim to give you the best, really. Have you heard about News of the South?
Yes, I have.
When was the first time you heard about us?
Sometime last year.
Okay, and how did you get to hear about us?
I just used to see posts on Facebook.
And, what was the best story that you've read from us?
One of them, to be honest.
All of them. Shanene loves all our stories. So you guys at News of the South, I think the team, you're doing very well. So Shanene likes everything about us.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Because she loves everything about us. So I think you guys are doing a great job. Do you ever wake up sometimes and feel like, oh, I don't want to go to work today, I don't want to
I do have those kind of days, to be honest.
So
especially when I know I'm not busy, I'll just wake up and say, you know what, today's my day off.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'll just give myself a day off, because I hardly do have a day off.
I think it's a good idea to have days off as well.
Mm-hmm. It's very, very important.
It's good for your body,
mm-hmm.
and for your mind. So any holidays planned this year?
I think I'll go away for my birthday, but I haven't decided where to.
Oh, your birthday is coming up soon.
Yes, it is.
When is that?
In June.
Wow. Since you're going away, it means there's no party then.
I had a party last year,
mm-hmm.
So this year, no, I'd rather go away.
Okay.
Somewhere beautiful.
Okay. So talking about your education, which schools did you attend in Zimbabwe?
I went to Morgan High School.
Wow, I also went to Morgan High.
Oh, did you?
Yes.
Oh, really?
Yes, Morgan High in Acadia.
Yes, all right. Which year was that?
Oh, do I remember? It's been a couple of years ago now. I just remember the grass was this high. That's what most people normally say. So I say exactly. That as well now.
Yeah. It's just much different. It's just much
different. Not a problem. I'm not moving too much. Am I being a good girl?
Just keep your eyes closed for a bit, sorry.
Yeah, so when I was at Morgan High, I remember they used to have a school bus. It was called Shakespeare.
Yes, yes, the Shakespeare bus, the yellow one.
Yes.
All right.
That was really popular, you know.
Yes,
when
yes.
When we were going out on the school trips, people used to say, which bus are we going out in? Shakespeare. Yes. Others used to like Shakespeare, others used to hate it.
It is, yeah.
Yeah. But I understand they've got a new bus now.
Is it?
Yeah,
I haven't really followed about Morgan High, to be honest.
They've got one of the modern buses.
Okay.
Yes. And when you were at Morgan, who was the headmaster again?
I can't remember.
Oh.
But we used to have one called, he used to hit us, oh my god, that man. What's his name again?
When I was there, the headmaster was Mr. Maunzi.
Yes, Mr. Maunzi, yes. And there was another one who was a deputy.
That was Mr. Chipoko.
No. There's one that used to beat so much.
I can't remember that one.
Oh my god, that guy used to beat us so much. He would be waiting at the gate if you're late for school.
Was he the deputy headmaster? Or he was a science teacher?
No, he wasn't a science teacher.
Okay.
I think he was the science teacher, to be honest.
Okay, I think I know that one. Yeah. We won't mention the name, though.
Yeah.
In case he's watching us, he won't like that. He won't like that. So at Morgan High School, what was your best sport or subject? What did you like most?
I used to play, my sport was basketball.
Okay.
And my best subject was English.
Oh, you were playing basketball. Was it Miss Mrs. Cohen?
Mrs. Jenner.
Mrs. Jenner, okay.
Yes, Mrs. Jenner, I think, or Mrs. Jenner, Mrs. Jenner.
See, I still remember all the teachers.
Yes.
Yeah, that's really good. I used to play basketball, netball. I used to play hockey as well. And I used to do athletics, cross country.
Mm-hmm. So I used to play cross athletic. Country.
I
used to hate running.
People used to say I chased the wind.
Is it?
Yes, I used to love running a lot.
Mm-hmm.
I used to do sports like the whole week. And I used to get home late, like 5, 6 o'clock. And my father would be really upset with me.
Is it?
I'd say, you're getting home 5, 6 o'clock? Are you the headmaster or something?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but that didn't stop me. I just continued doing sports.
Okay, so I'm just doing
So since you are a product of Morgan High School, have you done anything for the school after you left, or are you planning to do anything for them?
I haven't thought about that, and I haven't done anything, to be honest.
I think it's a good idea to be able to maintain the standards that were there the time that we were there.
Yes.
Or probably to raise the standards as well.
Yes, yes, yes.
So to everyone out there, just remember where you came from.
It's
important to go back to your schools.
Yes,
and
very,
do
very
something
important.
And give back something.
Something, yes, it is important. You're right.
So my makeup is almost done now.
Mm-hmm.
You can see the difference. You can see what beautiful Shanaynay has done to my face.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. I like it.
Beautiful.
I like it, Chantel.
Do you have a special lipstick or?
Yes, I do. I think it could be in the other bag.
Okay, let me just finish your eyes. Get on your
hands.
I I would have done your eyelashes, but it takes long. You know the single ones?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but it takes long to do.
Maybe somehow the time we can do
have
them.
Time.
Yeah. My driver is waiting patiently. We've got the other crew waiting as well.
Okay.
We are going to be doing some more interviews in Nottingham later on tonight. So
is it?
Yes.
Okay.
We've got quite a busy team. We've got another team in London. And we've got some events coming up this weekend as well. Other teams we'll be covering in Bradford as well.
Yeah.
So you should check out News of the South all the time, Chantel.
I will do. Mm-hmm.
Make sure you do so you don't miss a thing.
I will do, definitely.
Oh, Chantel is in love with my eyes. Take a look at my eyes, everyone. What do you like about my eyes?
Oh, I think it's just gorgeous, to be honest. You're really, really gorgeous.
Oh, thank you.
You have gorgeous eyes.
Thank you so much. When I go out there, I'll say to everyone, look at my eyes.
Yeah?
What do you think of my eyes?
They're very nice.
Look at my eyes, look at me. Shanae did my makeup today. I love it.
Okay, I'm just going to make you open your eyes wide and look at
me. I don't like you anything to get close to my eyes.
No, I'll try to be very gentle. Yeah, the black eyeliner just makes your eyes pop up more because they're beautiful. Just gently. I know you don't like it.
Nothing gets close to my toes and then my eyes.
My toes, why?
You know.
Sensitive?
Yeah. Ooh, wow. This is me. It is
so you need your favorite lipstick, not to the lips and then
we're done. Okay. I'll just go and find
Okay, I do party makeup and I charge £20 per head. That will just be for the makeup. And if it's going to be hair and makeup, it's £35. And when I say hair and makeup, I'm talking about styling, just styling on its own. And if it's wedding makeup and if it's a bride and six bridesmaids, it will be £450. Anyone extra will be £55 extra.
Wow.
Yeah.
Can I do your makeup?
Yeah, you can. Go ahead. Just add to whatever you want to.
And I'll be practicing on you. Is that okay?
No problem, Gina.
No, I think next time. Not today, next time.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm back and there you go.
All right. This is a very nice color.
Oh, you like it?
Yeah.
I'll get one for you as well.
Okay. Thank you.
So since you're always so busy, do you get enough time for yourself then?
I do try and create time for myself. Mm-hmm. You know, I do have to have a social life.
So after a busy day, what do you do when you get home?
When I get home, I have to clean and cook. You know, the kids will clean, but not as, you know, perfect as I want it to be. So I'll just probably go over and check. And if there's any messy spots, I'll probably go over it again and, you know, make sure it's thorough. Yeah, and then I'll do the cooking. And if I'm lazy, I'll just buy takeaway.
Takeaway Shanae.
But the kids
love me. I've got a new name for you.
I can actually sleep on porridge, to be honest.
Wow.
Yeah, I can actually have my oats because I love oats and Weetabix. So instead of having takeaway on a late night, I can just have the porridge. Then go
I've heard a few people say they can't sleep without eating sata.
What? Really?
Mm-hmm. They like to eat salsa every day.
Is it?
And meat as well.
Oh my god. Late at night or?
Anytime.
Anytime.
They cannot complete a day without meat.
Wow.
Do you eat a lot of meat?
I do eat meat, but not as much.
Okay.
Yeah. I used to eat a lot of meat, to be honest. But then, not as much.
So in terms of exercise, what do you do to keep in shape?
I don't do any exercises. I don't have the time.
Not at all. So no, how do you manage to keep in shape?
I just try and eat healthy. That's what I try to do. Yeah, that's
sounds
all.
Good.
I try and avoid eating late night snacks and late night big meals.
Okay.
Yeah, so I just stick to porridge, oats, your salad, and I go to bed. And it's actually working for me because I used to be quite a big girl as well.
So do you have your breakfast before you come every day or
not every day?
Breakfast sometimes?
I've got loads of porridge. If you go upstairs, I've got loads of porridge. So I always eat porridge when I'm here. And then I've got Subway there, so I just can buy like a salad or something during the day.
So how long to go now?
2 minutes. Just 2 minutes. I'm just touching it up now.
She's just doing the touch up now, and she will finish in about 2 minutes. All done now.
Yes.
Wow, take a look now. You saw me at the beginning. You can see me now. See the difference.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Chantel.
You're welcome.
Chantel Mungofa at Shani's Beauty Lounge in Nottingham.
Yes, Shani's Hair and Beauty Lounge, 394 Alfreton Road. Telephone number 074-692-50706.
Thank you so much.
Thank
Chantel.
You very much, Gina.
See
Thank
you soon.
Thank you. My pleasure.